We are here outside of the Stonewall, and who do I have with me? What is your name?
Oliver, her face.
What are your pronouns in and out of drag?
They, he, and hell, in and out of drag.
How'd you get your drag name?
I wanted something that was slutty and also a pun, and that sounded like a name. So I figured out Oliver sounded like all over, and I just started saying shit until it worked.
What's your current age and how long have you been doing drag?
I'm 23, and I've been doing drag for 4 years.
Where'd you grow up?
I grew up in Long Island.
What is your astrology big three? Do you know?
I'm a Capricorn sun, Leo moon, Cancer rising.
Who has inspired you most in your drag career?
Oh, most just like Disney villains in general. Definitely like also Andrew Jin, just being a king that does cool shit.
Yeah. What's been your favorite city or borough to perform in?
Always Brooklyn.
Brooklyn, baby. What's your current obsession?
Crocheting yarn.
Oh, I didn't know. Yeah. Oh, you made this?
Yes, I made this.
You made this?
I made this. Everything I wore tonight.
Oh, wait. Okay, cool. We're going to talk about that a little later.
Yeah.
So we just did your monthly All Kings and Things show here at Stonewall. What does that show mean to you?
For me, it means it's dedicated to Stormy Daudier. Picture right there, actually.
Let's get the picture.
Yeah. Stormy.
This is Stormy.
Beautiful. Stormy was the black lesbian drag king who threw the first punch at the Stonewall uprisings. And for me, it's just about reconnecting drag kings with our history at Stonewall.
Yeah.
We've always been here.
Yeah, I feel like kings and things are finally getting more representation that they've deserved and longed for so long. What does drag as a whole do for your confidence?
Oh, it makes me feel like I could do anything. Like I could wear nothing and still feel powerful and free. And also like giving me a lot of freedom in how I express my gender too.
I know you do a ton of drag story hours too. What's your favorite part of doing that?
Oh, for me, it's like just seeing the kids light up when they see someone colorful and shiny and spiky and seeing themselves be excited by something that seems new and like an art form they haven't been exposed to before.
What's your favorite drag story hour memory? Is there an interaction that stood out to you the most?
Yeah, so I had a kid at the super politicized event where, and there's a picture of where there's a bunch of politicians in the background, and he just wanted to touch my spikes and feel my spikes, and it's just a photo of him playing with my hair while there's
so cute.
All these politicians.
Yeah, I love like when kids come to brunch and stuff and I get pictures of like holding that, like it's just so fun. It's
yeah,
just so fun.
They're
having
excited.
Fun. It's just
yeah.
joy. Yeah, we're just joy.
Fucking cool to them.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite drag story hour book?
Oh, I love actually, it's a book called Twas the Night Before Pride. And it is actually about the Stonewall uprisings and tells kids the story of pride and what pride is.
What's your favorite number you've been performing recently?
Recently, I did a 10-minute long number talking about story hour and how it's become so politicized and seen yeah. as something that's dangerous with all the drag bands going around. So really being able to talk about that.
You do lots of mixes or do you mostly do straight through songs with like a concept?
I love a straight through song with a concept.
Got it, personally. Who are some of your favorite drag kings?
Some of my favorite drag kings, obviously Mystery Mel Kiki, Uncle Freak, drag kings and things in general, Klondike, Zaddy Addy. I could go on forever.
Who are some of your favorite drag queens?
Oh, Amanda Pork, obviously. I also love Stassi. I love Amygdala also. A lot of different cool folks.
Would you ever want to consider doing TV or film?
Oh, yeah. I would love to. Manifesting that I'll be a Dragula winner.
Okay. I can see that. I honestly see that for you.
I can see it for you.
What's your favorite color?
Purple.
Least favorite color?
Like beige, I guess.
Beige. Very boring, yeah.
Yeah.
Last movie that made you laugh?
Oh, I don't even
know. Or a TV show. I'll take a TV show.
I love
show.
A New Girl.
New Girl?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like you're the, like, other people have said this in this interview series. Like, I love New Girl.
I love rewatching New Girl.
So weird, yeah. The bisexuality really jumped out, honestly.
No, yeah. It's for the bisexual.
Yeah. Favorite childhood memory?
Oh, there's a video of me when I was a kid, and I'm riding a bike, and I've always been like this, and I get off the bike, and I go, action, baby. And then I get back on, video recording, and I go, let's get back to the show. So, you know, I was made.
It's always been a production.
It's always been a production.
How do you fit under the queer umbrella?
I identify as pansexual, queer, non-binary, and trans.
What's the best thing since sliced bread?
Drag, baby.
Drag. I think it existed before sliced bread, honestly.
It existed before sliced bread. That's a great point.
What is your favorite makeup brand?
NYX. I'm a cheap bitch.
One makeup product Oliver can't live without?
Oh, the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. I go through so much foundation.
A lot of people mix that with other foundation. Like, I feel like people always go back to Fit Me, honestly.
Yes, because I mix it with Juvia's Place. But
exactly, yeah, I hear that a lot. I hear that a lot. And your skin looks so, like, so matte, but also kind of, like, glowy. Like, it's so good.
So much shimmer, but a matte foundation.
Best compliment you've ever been given?
I love, people will tell me that they've never seen anything like me before, and that's my favorite.
So exciting, yeah.
Yeah, I just want to be new. I was wondering, sorry. I saw you. I was like, is he sneaking away? I'm glad you came back. I love you.
What's the worst compliment you've ever been given?
Someone asked me if I was trying to go for having the ass of a white man. And a white man said this to me.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I think my ass is pretty nice. I don't think this is a white man's ass.
I mean, let's ask the audience.
That was a critique I
That's
was given.
So interesting.
Yeah.
It's not performance. I don't know what that means.
That was
he was drunk. We're gonna skip past it.
Yeah.
If you could relive any year of your life, what would you pick?
I guess like really little when I was a kid. Probably, I guess 2005.
Before any responsibilities.
Yes.
Oh, 2005, that's a good, yeah.
It's good year. Good year for fashion. That's why I'm like this also.
Where do you see Oliver in 5 years?
My goal is just to be able to do drag full time. I want to be creating shows for people. I want to be traveling. Ideally by then I will have one Dragula traveling the world. I just want to be doing drag all the time.
I know during your show, we talked a little bit about going to school, getting your major. Can you tell us where you went to college?
Yeah, I went to Nassau Community College.
For what?
Early childhood education. I was a daycare teacher for a long time.
And what made you pick that?
I love kids, and I feel like understanding how kids work helps you understand how yourself works.
Yeah. And also, I feel like those positions are really important for queer people to be able to build a foundation for people to realize, like, hey, people are like you. You know what I mean?
Literally,
like,
just existing,
giving
that
exists
being visible,
is this being visible exactly
so important.
Such an important role for you. Yeah,
just
yeah.
Being able to exist.
So, thank you for doing that. Thank you for your work.
Yeah.
What does the word queer mean to you? How would you identify it personally?
Queer to me is in so many different areas. It can describe your gender. It can describe your politics and describe how you experience joy. For me, it's a lot about joy and being proud in yourself as you come.
Yeah. And speaking of politics, we mentioned earlier, like, there's tons of anti-trans legislature going around, these drag ban bills. What would you say to those people who are actively behind those bills?
Is that really the best use of legislation? All three of my jobs would be illegal in a lot of the states. And it's also just, what are you doing? What good is
it? It's not that deep.
It's
literally not that deep.
It's literally not that deep.
Yeah.
It's like making clowning illegal. It's
right.
The same thing.
What part of New York City do you live in? You said
you live in Long Island.
You still live there.
I still
live there. Oh my gosh, the commute, baby.
It wasn't that bad. It was an hour. I pray to the parking gods.
Yeah. It's always at night. Like, I've done gigs in Long Island and coming back, it's always like,
coming back,
when is the train coming?
Yeah.
What's
happening? Yeah.
What's your least favorite subway line?
I'd say the A, because my ex lives off of it.
That's fair. I live off the A.
You live off the A? The A is good for a lot of things. Okay.
Getting somewhere quickly is one of those.
Getting somewhere quickly, yeah.
Getting intercourse is not a good thing.
No.
We've worked together a ton of times.
Yeah.
Very grateful to know you.
Me too.
What's been your favorite part about being a part of some Kashas? I've had you my Invasions,
yeah.
Warped Tour. What's your favorite part about being in a Kash show? Not necessarily mine, but in general.
I feel like you get to know a lot of other artists and, like, I love the key backstage, you know, just hanging out. And even just being able to connect and seeing other people's art is really exciting. And I always feel like I can do my weird shit at your show.
Yeah, so. Yeah. Oh, always welcome. I will take
it's the best kind of vibe.
Best venue to work at in New York City, in your opinion?
To work at?
Or a few. You can name a few so you don't make anybody mad.
Star Bar.
Star Bar.
Star Bar has been great in producing. Stonewall has been amazing. Yeah, I'll say that.
What's one venue you haven't performed at yet, but you want to?
I haven't performed at The Bush yet, the new one.
Oh, I haven't heard it.
Yeah, The Bush is a new little bar.
And where? In Bush? Oh, Slay. Fun.
It's a new one.
All right, I'll have to check it out. One performer you want to work with who you haven't yet?
Landon Sider.
Mm-hmm. The two names go together. It could be father and son. Like, they go together. Yeah. It's the same
thing. I'd love to work with him.
Well, you heard it here first. Landon, if you're listening, if you're watching, you have a drag son waiting for you. Are you working on anything else right now in a producer role? I know you've produced this. You're making this happen, which is very important. Are you in the works of producing anything else?
Yeah, so I produce a monthly Rocky Horror Drag and Burlesque.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, so the next one's going to be June 25th at Purgatory. So I'm always working on Rocky.
What do you do when you can't sleep?
When I can't sleep, I go on TikTok or I watch Bee and Puppy Cat.
What makes you really angry? What's one thing that's gonna really set you off?
Thinking about all this like bullshit laws, like literally thinking that all of my fucking jobs would be illegal.
I know you keep saying that. I'm like, they really would be.
It's crazy, and they really would be. Because I present to these kids and I say that to them. What are examples of discrimination? The fact that this conversation is illegal in a lot of states.
Literally.
Yeah.
But we're having it. We're not going anywhere. Yeah. We're not going anywhere. What is your dream vacation?
My dream vacation. Oh, I'd love to go to Puerto Rico for so long. My family's from Puerto Rico. I'd love to perform there also.
Mm-hmm. So, I'm sure you could. Drag is pretty big in Puerto Rico, right?
Yeah, I know a lot of kings there too.
What's your biggest motivation? What gets you out of bed?
Like just being the person that I've always dreamed of. Mm-hmm. I used to stare into the stone, like from outside, being like, let me in when I was too little to get in.
Yeah.
Even I was starting drag at 19, so I couldn't get into a lot of places, but doing that for them.
Do you have a daily routine?
I smoke weed every day. That's probably
to start the day or all times of day?
All times of day. Anytime I can.
What is between my what routine. Am I touching?
Oh my god. You're falling into a bush.
I almost just fell. Oh man.
You're like on the most uneven ground ever. Yeah.
I didn't know that was there.
Oh my god.
You're getting the real deal here.
Yeah.
So, where do you store your drag? Do you have a drag room or like a drag corner?
Yeah, great question. I'm living with my mom, so it's just wherever it fits. A lot of
we'll
my
take
drag
it.
Is in my car. Wherever it fits.
We'll take. Oh, you drive to your gigs?
I do drive.
Okay.
The past 4 years, I've been taking the LIRR.
Right. Exactly.
But now I'm Zooming.
That's so nice.
Oh, yeah, it's such a relief.
Whenever I work with someone who, like, has a car and they can just, like, pull all their suitcases, they can bring so much drag with them.
It makes such a difference. It's wild. Yeah, like, I can bring as many shoes. You want shoes are in the back of my car?
Right, and these, like, this takes up a suitcase.
Literally.
A suitcase.
It's made such a difference. Yeah, I was literally, like, on the train. I used to have my grandma car on the train.
What makes you feel the most creative?
Oh, working with other people, being inspired by other drag.
Who are some of your mentors? People who are maybe mentors who?
Definitely.
Okay.
Like, was really pivotal for me, especially in producing. Mm-hmm. And learning how to do this, how to email venues, and being a king in that space, too.
You make a lot of your own looks, right?
Yeah.
Are you self-taught?
Yes. So everything I'm self-taught. I taught myself how to crochet pretty recently. All my punk shit, I am self-taught.
Yeah. What's your favorite part about coming up with a look?
Oh, because it's like, how could I explain this to someone else?
Yeah.
How could I buy this?
You like to design,
off?
You like to like actually build
design,
it.
Because a lot of times I already have things in my head.
Yeah.
My own twisted little universe. So bringing it to life and being like, oh my God, I made this and it's in my hands.
What's the last meme you have saved on your phone?
That's a good question.
Or your current favorite meme?
My current favorite meme. Oh, I love like TikTok trends, I guess. Memes on TikTok or something.
If you had a drag son, what would their name be? Do you have any? Do you have any drag
kids? I don't have any.
I didn't think so.
Son,
yeah.
No.
What would their name be if their last name was Her Face?
That's a good question. Maybe Kissin'?
Kissin'? Kissin' on Her Face. I'm trying to think of any puns.
Of any?
I think you got the best one.
I got a copyrighted.
So. Yeah. Best piece of advice a family member or a loved one has given to you that has stuck?
I just feel like people reminding me to just be myself throughout this. Mm-hmm. And like, that I'm doing okay, Just keep going.
During the pandemic, you did a lot of digital drag. You've done some of my shows during digital drag. What'd you learn about yourself from doing that?
Oh, I hate being confined in small, tiny spaces. And video shoots test your patience.
Yeah. You also want everything to be perfect.
Yeah, you want everything to be perfect, and it's so hard fitting within this tiny little box. When, like, in a bar, I can do a bar. I could bounce around. I could jump around the place. But yeah.
It's also not something that will live on to haunt you for the rest of your life. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
it's not something that's stone. Exactly. Yeah. It's not in stone.
That's also the good part of it, that I can have some of my performances.
Totally.
In stone too.
Do you have a favorite number that you did from digital drag era?
This one was from before digital drag, but I really cemented it. Actually, I'll say this one. I have a number that's about. It's a boxing number about like being trans and feeling like you have to fight your body. Mm-hmm. And I was dealing with that a lot in the pandemic, so being able to make that felt really good.
Do you have, what is the best way to get a hold of you?
Oh, like text, DMs are not the best text.
I was DMing you all day, like, are we still on? Are we good? Are we good? Can we do it? And then you saw me in person, you're like, yes, I saw it.
Yes.
What's happening? It has not happened.
But it's like answering is hard.
Yeah, it's tough. What about Oliver? Do you hope excites people?
His queerness in every facet has helped people think I'm a little sexy. You know, a little sexy, and just like also, I had someone say to me after a show like, I've never seen someone with my body type be so naked on stage. So also like,
totally.
You could express yourself like this too.
What's your number one priority this year?
My health and spending more time with friends.
I've got 3 more questions for you.
Great.
Any fun projects you can share? I know you said you're going to be here end of June, right? Rocky Horror is end of
Rocky's
June 25th.
June 25th at Purgatory. We do that monthly, but we're looking for our new home currently.
Mm-hmm.
And other than that, I guess we'll just have to find out.
And where can we follow you?
You can follow me on Instagram at Oliver, like the orphan, _her_face. Oliver _her_face.
I love chatting with you. It's always great seeing
you. Thank you so much.
So handsome as always.
Thank you. You're beautiful. Thank you for coming out.
And we'll see you next time. You can catch us here at the Stonewall.
Oh, yeah, at Stonewall.
Bye. Happy Pride.
Happy Pride.
Mwah.